God is good, and with each day that passes, brings us a day closer to the launch of Camelot Unchained. This is the Nathan NAPALM channel, and if you're new here, please consider subscribing, especially if you're interested in Camelot Unchained, Pantheon, Rise of Fallen, old school MMOs, RPGs, all that kind of thing. Today, I want to talk about the basics of how PvP actually works in Camelot Unchained, as far as we know and the information that we have gathered. So let's get right to it. Camelot Unchained is a PvP-focused game. The PvE in the game, or anything dealing not with fighting other characters, or other players, I should say, is going to be still influencing the PvP. So yes, you can play the game just as a crafter. You know, you could go into the battle actually as just a person who fixes structures, or repairs things, or makes armor and gear and siege weapons for the war effort. So there is some PvE gameplay, but it all goes back towards being all focused back to the PvP. In other words, you will not be leveling up. You will not be going out and fighting random things to level your character up to get to the end game, which would be PvP, which is something at the launch of Dark Age of Camelot you did. This game is focused completely around PvP. Now, it's not just random, you don't just go out and fight every person you see. So the game is split up into three realms. You have the Arthurians, the Tuatha De Danann, and the Vikings. And they each have their own area, okay? Their starting area, I guess you could say. And this starting area is a safe zone. The other realms cannot take over your actual original place. You can see it here on the map that we do have a section, and you can see it's in a little triangle shape, so that you get the maximum kind of clash as the realms move deeper in. Now, if you notice all these little segments, they're broken apart, okay? So each little, what looks like a little area or a zone or a little state almost, if those had to be acquired by the realm. So if you acquire it, if your realm owns that particular piece of land, then it connects to your realm. So if it was a lopsided war and the Vikings, I'll use them as an example, if the Vikings were completely dominating, then they would have more landmass. Do you see what I mean? Now, just because you own it doesn't mean now it's part of your land and no one else can come into it. Now, all those sections as they attach can be reclaimed by the other realms. Now, first they'd have to break it away from control of the Vikings, and then it would split away from their continent, if you see what I'm saying, and drift away, and then it can be claimed by the Arthurians or by the Tuatha De Danann. So you're constantly fighting not just to win or not just for specs, but also to actually make your landmass of your particular realm bigger and actually get something for it. So I think that's pretty cool. And I think as we move further into development and everything, I think we're going to learn a lot of really cool other things to do with that. But that's the basis of what the realm war looks like. Now, of course, it's worth mentioning to anybody who's new to Camelot Unchained that each realm isn't just a team you pick with the same classes and the same races. It's totally different races for each realm, and it's totally different classes for each realm. So it's almost like there's three MMOs built into one, because the world's going to look different in a different realm, the classes are completely different, and the races are completely different. So, you know, it's really built to create a realm pride in Camelot Unchained and make people interested in their particular group. So it's almost like a faction. You pick between the three factions and you fight other real people. Like, that's what you do in the game. So it's very interesting, and it, of course, to anybody who played Dark Age of Camelot, of course, that's going to be your first knee-jerk reaction, is it's going to remind you of that, and it is a lot like that. Mark Jacobs is heading Camelot Unchained's development, and he also headed Dark Age of Camelot and lots of MUDs and things before that as well, so that's why you're seeing that similarity. And if you talk to anybody that played Dark Age of Camelot back in the day, they will tell you, even to this day, that it was the best PvP focused game in my and many others' opinions ever made. because it just works so well. Not having two sides competing against, but having three. What ends up happening is, say the Vikings are dominating, and they're just taking everything. It's just completely ridiculous. They're dominating everything. What will end up naturally happening is the Arthurians and the Tuatha De Danann will end up kind of working together to take down the Vikings, right? Like, then, you know, it balances. It's just easier. For some reason, it just naturally balances when you have a tri-realm system like that, and I don't know why, it just does. It's just how it works. So it's very interesting, and I really enjoy the being able to pull land and things like that to get more natural resources, to build better structures, etc. And that's another key part of Camelot Unchained that kind of separates it from most of the competition, is the building. Like, you know, actual building and, you know, actually creating these towers and these defenses and walls and things. And it's not just like generic placeholder, you're actually building these, like vector-based building. And it looks really cool, and it reminds me a lot of Shadowbane. I talk a lot, when I talk about Camelot Unchained, I talk a lot about Dark Age Camelot, but honestly, because of this open world building system, it's definitely actually more comparable in gameplay, or as far as the feeling, the spirit of the game, to Shadowbane. So that's worth mentioning if you ever played that game. I had a decent little following back in the day and was definitely way beyond it, you know, ahead of its time, the kind of game they were going for at that time with Shadowbane. So I just think it's a really cool concept. I think Camelot Unchained is definitely one of the more unique MMORPGs in development right now. I love it when a game has a vision. You know, Pantheon Rise of Fallen definitely has a vision of player versus environment. Camelot Unchained definitely has a vision for being a player versus player game. So they have this vision and they're going for it. It's a niche, and it's going to be better than being generic and trying to please everybody, but instead just trying to please your niche. So the people who like this particular thing. And I honestly think there's a lot of people who will end up coming to Camelot Unchained at launch from the old days of Dark Age Camelot, which was a very successful MMORPG. I mean, it's still running right now with the subscription model, as far as I'm aware. They were talking about going free to play at one point. But anyway, that doesn't matter. It had a good, healthy population in its day, and you know, it's an old game now, and a lot of people have left it because it's, you know, it's right now Dark Age of Camelot's a shell of its, you know, former self. So a lot of people over the years have left. So we all, everybody needs a home. I believe Camelot Unchained is the best home if you're interested in player versus player. And Pantheon, of course, Rise of the Fallen being the best home I could imagine for a player versus environment game. Well, I hope you learned something new here today. Thank you for joining me. I just wanted to give a brief overview of the player versus player type gameplay we're going to see in Camelot Unchained when the game finally does launch. And leave me a comment down below. Share with your friends and family on social media. And I appreciate you. And until next time, God bless and happy gaming.